sí, ahí está, gracias. Piedra del Indio, right there. It's a wonky ass bridge.
So Coyhaique is like a real city, and it's right kind of smack in the middle of the Carretera Austral now. So it's a starting point for a lot of tourists as well. So after 2.5 decently long days in Coyhaique, spent them running a lot of errands, and now I'm going to Reserva Nacional Coyhaique. It's about 2 miles north of Coyhaique, and I hear it has a lot of nice trails. So I'm gonna go check that out, and tomorrow we go to Cerro Castillo, where I plan to do a 5-day-long solo trek through some of the most beautiful landscapes in all of Chile. I kind of just followed Google Maps driving directions, which isn't always the smartest thing to do. So I'm walking along the side of a highway now. But luckily there's a nice little footpath, if you can call this one. We have made it to the entrance. Vamos. Real spike in the temperature. Holy moly. Just got real hot. Oh, this entrance is quite far. Now we made it. Sign is telling me what to do if I come face to face with a puma. But that event is unlikely as it stands, and it's even more unlikely for one to attack you, as these animals are insanely timid and actively avoid contact with humans. There's a museum here, and there's a little house. It looks pretty cool in there, but it's all locked. It does look a little spooky, so we're not even gonna go inside because it's also called Casa Bruja, witch house. Suddenly, I'm in a field, and I found a walking stick / samurai sword to keep myself busy. So it appears as if the trail ends here, but the map said it loops around the entire lake, so let's go. So according to this, this habitat has 3 enemies. 1, the trout. 2, the otter. 3, me. Yeah, I don't know. Well, I guess the otter and the trout are invasive species, and then we're enemies because we contaminate and destroy these habitats with our presence. That's why it's important to walk along the trails to not destroy anything important. These woods are insane. We have a little baby lagoon. This is the third one I've seen today. This is Laguna Venus. We have made it to the fourth and final lagoon on this trail, and that's Laguna de los Sapos. It's right here. This is why all these forests are so at risk for wildfires. It's because of this stuff. Partially. But that might just be some of the best kindling you'll ever find. That is flammable as fuck. And apparently, according to my cousin Johnny, all of that shows that this ecosystem is healthy. We made it. Made it out of the park, Reserva Nacional Coyhaique. Now it's time to walk back into the city. And I've walked 12 miles today already, so I'm pretty tired. It's been a long day of walking, but we made it back to Coyhaique. Didn't see any pumas, but we still got time for that. Back in the city. So I've spent the day leaving the town, the city of Coyhaique. Got two successful hitchhikes. One in a red pickup truck. They brought me about 13 kilometers to Valle Simpson. And then I got picked up by a school bus that just dropped me off in El Blanco. So we're about halfway to where I have to go. And that's Villa Cerro Gatillo, where I hope to spend the night and camp out before doing the trekking that starts tomorrow. So, good day of hitchhiking, but only halfway there. Let's keep going. So, very long day of hitchhiking, started around 12 and I think it's like close to 7 now. Four different rides, one in a red pickup truck with a family, second on a school bus, third in a truck with a guy that was carrying a bunch of bread, and fourth, another friendly guy in a pickup truck that brought me all the way to Villa Cerro Gatillo. Arrived at this pretty stunning campsite right in the valley, the little town of Villa Cerro Gatillo, which is well inside the whole national reserve. So tomorrow is day one of my 4-day hike, and I'm already well away from any cell service or Wi-Fi, so I probably should have told mother about this before I embark, but I'm safe and sound, currently prepping for tomorrow, making some trail mix. So final preparations before a big, challenging 4 days. Very, very excited.